Hi there.
In this video, we'll be learning about creating an index in InDesign, so let's get started. I'm using the same document I used in the last session, except now I have randomly added a few words to facilitate our index creation. Let's first show the index panel, and for that, go to Window, and then Type and Tables, and select Index. Let me put this panel aside, and let me zoom in as well. All right. Now you see this word Tokyo, that's going to be part of our index, and I've added it on different pages as well. So with the word highlighted, click the small plus button at the bottom of the index panel to create an index. You'll find the word sitting there already, so just hit add all. And it shall add all the instances of the word Tokyo in the document to the index, and then hit done. Now let's select another word, Sydney, and repeat the process of adding it to the index. Ensure that you always click Add All and not Add, because if you click Add, it will only add that one instance of the highlighted word. Similarly, let's add Munich to our index, and I think I have one more here somewhere. It's here, it's Istanbul, so let's quickly add this as well. If you scroll through the index, you'll find the added words along with the page numbers they are cut on. It's time to generate the index, and for that, I'll have to add another page from the Pages panel. So click the small plus button at the bottom of the Pages panel to create a new page, and then go to the page. Let's minimize our Pages panel here, and to generate the index, click this icon which is to the left of the plus button at the bottom of the index panel, and a pop-up notification will appear, from where you can add a title to your index. We'll keep it as it is and hit OK. The moment you hit OK, the cursor will be loaded, so take it to the top left corner of your index page and drag it, much like you drag a text box, and the index shall be displayed. Now, when you examine the paragraph styles panel, you'll find three styles added automatically. Index level 1 style is the one applied to the names here. Index title is the main heading, and index section head is the heading applied to the index level 1. Although these styles apply to the index, they're still in the default setup, hence we need to style them. So let's double click index title and then go to basic character formats and change the font to Museo Sans. Also update the font style to 700 and hit OK. Now double click index level 1 and move to basic character formats and change the font to Museo Sans and font style to 500 and hit OK. Lastly, double click the index section head and move to basic character formats and update the font to Museo Sans and font style to 500. Let's switch to the character color tab and change the color to red and then hit OK. And now the index is styled as well. Let's hit the shortcut Command J on a Mac or Control J on a PC and Enter 1 for page 1 to go to the first page. Now let's say I remove the word Tokyo from this paragraph and another word Munich from the paragraph on the right. Once you've deleted instances of your index words, you need to go to the index panel and click this small button that says Update Preview. Hey, but we just clicked it. Why has nothing happened to my index? That's because that has just updated the preview on my index panel. So when you go to the index panel to check the word Munich, you see now it just shows to be existing on page 3 here. So to have the update reflect on your index, we need to generate the index once again. So let's click the Generate Index button, and in the pop-up notification, ensure that the Replace Existing Index box is checked, and hit OK. You'll find that page 1 has been removed from the word Munich. But didn't we also remove the word Tokyo from page 1? Then why is it still showing? Let's jump to page 1 to find out. And to jump to page 1, we need to hit the shortcut Command J on a Mac or Control J on a PC, and then Enter 1 and hit OK. You see, although we deleted the word Tokyo from the first paragraph, the word is still there on this page, but somewhere else. It is sitting here in this paragraph, hence showing on our index page. So be wary of a situation like this to avoid any unnecessary confusions. All right, guys, that concludes our session. I hope you've enjoyed it. So I'm going to see you in the next one in just a bit. Goodbye.